Hi, I'm George Hirsch. Welcome to George Hirsch Lifestyle. One dessert that you're going to want to add to your own repertoire is my chocolate torta. Very simply made with ingredients you probably have in the cupboard right now. We're going to start with 1 cup of unsweetened cocoa powder. And to that, we're going to add in 1 1/4 cups of pure cane sugar. Blend the two of them together. And it's actually going to resemble, I'm sure you're familiar with cinnamon sugar. We could actually call this like cocoa sugar. But this will ensure later when you're mixing the cocoa and the sugar in with the flour, it blends in nice and smooth. So once that's all set, you can put the cocoa powder off to the side a second and begin to mix the other parts of the dry ingredients. And to this, we're going to add in 1 cup of all-purpose flour, and it actually makes for a very, very moist cake. By using just the flour and the cornstarch, along with the cocoa powder and the sugar, it's about 1/4 cup of cornstarch in there, and that helps the cake to bind and be moist. We'll put in 1/2 teaspoon of salt and 1 teaspoon of baking soda. I'm going to use 1 whole egg, 1 egg white, not the yolk. I don't want to add the 2 yolks in it. It actually will help make it slightly more tender when I'm just using the whites. It won't make it as crusty on the outside. So to that, the 1 whole egg and the 1 white. Now I'm going to add in 1/2 teaspoon of pure vanilla extract and pour that into the cocoa powder so it begins to dissolve. Just 1 cup of water, all blended in, and that there's no cocoa lumps or sugar lumps left in it. Now I'll add in the remaining of the water. And you'll also notice I didn't just dump all the water in at one shot. I did it in stages, about 2 to 3 stages, just to make sure that everything is blended in together. We'll add in a small amount of the chocolate first and begin to fold that in. And this is really just one of those no-fail cakes. It's simple. If you're even short of a little milk, you notice there's no milk even in this cake. And then at the very, very end, I'm going to add in 1/3 cup of butter that's melted. And again, with the butter, it gets added in a couple stages. In a 9-inch cake pan that's pre-greased, I'll add in 1 piece of parchment paper, which I like to add a lot when I bake on the bottom. It helps sometimes keep the bottom from getting too much of an overdeveloped crust. 325 degree oven for about 45 minutes. And the best way to see if it's done is, you'll see that it's pulled away from the edges of the cake pan. So you press down lightly with your finger, and if there's no resistance, it's another good way to tell if it's done. We're gonna let it cool for about 45 minutes to an hour, and then we're gonna cut right into it, because boy, it smells great. Okay, now that the cake has cooled, very simply, turn it upside down. You notice I'm using a piece of parchment paper, and that will keep the cake from actually sticking to your hand. Just tap it out gently, and you can see the parchment paper on the bottom. Now's the time you want to remove it and make a really nice slice of the chocolate torta, topping it off with a little bit of a nice chantilly cream on the side. Nothing better than a nice piece of rich, moist chocolate cake.
Tender sweet chocolate torta with a dollop of fresh whipped cream.
If I can do it, you can do it. We'll see you real soon.